Hey everybody, I'm Sarah Wiseman, and today for our Spiritual Psychic podcast, we are talking about the idea of what traditions are worth keeping. Learn why the past may or may not still hold value for us. Now, this is a super interesting concept for me because, as many of you know, I'm Aquarius. I'm mostly Aquarius. Most of my planets are in Aquarius. And, you know, so Aquarius is the future thinker or the visionary or the one that doesn't hold a lot of, doesn't have a lot of attachment to the way things have been done. It's just not in our nature. And yet the world is, you know, made up of many, many people who really, really value traditions, or they really find comfort and enjoyment in doing things, you know, the way that they've been done, or the way that was handed down to them. And so the question is, what traditions are worth keeping if we are attempting to expand as beings, you know, take our awareness to the furthest level? What from the past did we bring forward with us? Do we just kind of chuck it all away? Do we keep some of it? How do we decide? And I like to think of it in a couple different ways. First, I like to question traditions as belief systems. And so if you have a lot of traditions in your life that come from, say, generations back, the ancestry, the culture or place you have grown up in or been advised by, maybe religious traditions, maybe just sort of things you've always done, it would be interesting to look and see how much of those traditions are based on belief systems, you know, sort of this group thought that creates a way of being, and how much you actually agree with that now. So, for example, Thanksgiving, and you know, Thanksgiving in America is usually based, or has often been based, on this idea of the turkey, right? Almost everyone in my family is vegetarian or vegan. So this tradition of the turkey has very little value for most of us. And so when this started to come up, like, oh, it's this holiday, we need to have a turkey. Well, actually, we don't. And we don't. But looking at the value system, looking at where did this habit come from? Where did this tradition come from? And is it of use or importance to us anymore? And it's not. And if you look back, you know, there's this whole myth, a lot of us were raised on, that the pilgrims shared with the Native Americans, and just like, you know, that's not how it was. And then the turkey board began to promote the turkey. And so it's just an advertising thing. It's just a promotional thing. It's probably something that happened once that was carried on and on and on. And then, of course, profit centers get involved, and suddenly we've got this massive thing we're all following. Why? That's just one idea. Another idea is, if you have traditions that are based on religious structures that maybe you were raised with. I know a lot of people were raised Catholic, and at one time the idea was you couldn't have meat on Fridays. So I don't know if that's still a thing or not, but anyway, when I was growing up, that was a big deal, and you couldn't have meat on Fridays, so people had fish. That was this was before vegetarianism had sort of taken control. But now there's probably a reason that this tradition started, but when we look now at how it affects us, is this tradition of value to us? Is it of value still? And so it's almost like a sense of taking everything that you do that's become ritualized or become this is the way we do things. Like, especially around the holidays, these rituals come in really hard. Like, why do we have a turkey? Why do we have a Christmas tree? Why do we have stockings for those who do this? Why do we have a basket at Easter? And on and on and on. And these are, you know, sort of the sort of mainstream sort of Christian religion ideas or rituals ideas that are pretty common or used to be pretty common in mainstream US, changing rapidly now, thank goodness. But just looking at it and just looking at what's meaningful to you, just because something's been done and done and done and done, you know, that doesn't mean that it has value now. Finally, a lot of you guys have watched multiple Star Trek episodes where, you know, they're not supposed to interfere with the planet, but then they go and they're on the planet and one of the people drops their pen and, you know, you're never supposed to leave anything behind, but they drop their pen. And then 800 years later, they go back to that same society to see how they're doing. And they find that they're worshiping the pen as a magical being. And this is this idea of it starts, it's good one time, and then suddenly that's all we're doing. It would be a wonderful experience to think about what traditions you're following and if they have value to you. They may just kind of break free from habitual ways of doing things and see what else is there. You may decide, I love the habitual way, perfect for me, that's what I want to do. Or you may be like, yeah, I could really be free to do something entirely different. Anyway, take a look, see what it feels like to you. Thank you for listening. I'm Sarah Wiseman. You'll find me at sarahwiseman.com.